I would say this. There are a couple of answers to that. One is algae. So in other words, which may not sound like new news, because, and it isn't, people have been trying to do this for quite a while, but there is a trajectory by which we can get there in biofuels, and if there are any biofuels that have a chance, algae is one. Simply because small is good. I won't bore you with the biology, but you can get more, the energy density in algae is 30 to 50 times that of any terrestrial plant. The problem is making it work in the real world. So the jury is still out on this. Will there be enough investment to get over the hump in terms of the technology? That's number one. Number two is synthetic fuels. So there are breakthroughs with respect to how do you take large amounts of energy. So for instance, off-peak wind, the wind doesn't blow when we need it the most. It blows mostly in the middle of the night when we need it the least. So what are you going to do with that off-peak wind? Well, you can take that and use large amounts of carbon dioxide and synthesize hydrocarbons with that. So that's a very interesting technology. Again, people have been trying to do this since Jimmy Carter was in office in the late 70s without any real success. I believe that there have been breakthroughs in this thing made very recently. My third answer to that is cold fusion. Not everybody believes in this. I happen to believe that this is legitimate science. I don't think we're right around the corner from harvesting this in any meaningful way, but I am a believer in the fact that this is legitimate science and that there's no a priori reason, there's no off the top of your head reason why we can't, why fusion needs to take place at the temperature and at the speed that it does on the surface of the sun or in a hydrogen bomb. It's just an academic, it's just an intellectual error to presume that fusion has to happen in 10 to the minus 22nd seconds. I don't believe that's true. And I think that the proof on this thing is right around the corner.